She's a lesbian!
Oh. Hello, beautifuls. Welcome back to my Chanel. And welcome to the gorgeous Rolishian dude.
Hello, I'm on Ket.
On the Ket girl. So, today do we have a little treat for you, my loves? For you.
We also have Ket for you.
Yeah, Susan's going to be like,
Stop talking about Ket.
I don't like this conversation.
This explicit conversation demonetized.
Yeah.
So, I have actually discovered another show that has been scrubbed from the internet. So, you can actually get this through nefarious means. But you will not find an episode on YouTube. And that is because it is literally blocked worldwide. So, fingers crossed this makes it through. Please, this is a commentary video. It's fair use, girls. Today we are going to be watching season one, episode one of
My Gout,
My Strange Addiction. And to be honest, I vaguely remember watching this back in the day. I want to say this was already on when I was like in London. So like maybe 11 years old, 10, 11 years old,
something like that. I think it was like 2008 to 2009.
Oh, really? What, when it started?
Yeah, I think it was around that time.
So I have absolutely no idea what to expect with My Strange Addiction. Judging from the name, it does sound a little bit like,
what's she up to? She weird?
It's going to be something shocking.
It's going to be off the scale, I think. I don't even know how off the scale it's going to be. So why don't we shimmy over to the left?
Shimmy to the left and dash your boobs. This program depicts addictive behaviors that are dangerous and risky initial viewers do not attempt.
Do not attempt.
I'm absolutely addicted to sleeping with my blow dryer. I don't
want to. Oh no, fake lady.
The blow dryer just attacked me that night. When I see scars on her arms, that's a problem. People will tell me all the time.
Did you see that lady's hair? She's having an affair with a blow dryer. So much has happened in like 12 seconds.
Yeah,
what was this shot of, like, the hairdryer. My name's Maggie and I sleep with my blow dryer.
Do you think, the only thing I can think of now is maybe it's the noise? Like, noise is comforting to her or something? Hello, house fire. Do you know what solved my headache? A good old-fashioned
house fire.
Not to rule me anymore.
It would be so noisy.
I love eating toilet paper.
You should really consider not doing it at all.
That's an icon.
Really. Doesn't toilet paper have like a chemical in it?
Yes.
Toilet paper has like a chemical in it,
yes,
right?
Yeah, it's not. Yes. But also, the body can't break down cellulose. We can't like digest cellulose. So that's an interesting. No.
Time to internally bleed.
No.
My strange addiction.
Well, so hair dryers versus toilet paper.
Yeah.
Oh, this is nice. Very the same.
My name's Lori. I'm 31 years old. I live in Austin, Texas.
31.
I am a mother to a beautiful little 3-year-old named
She's
Andrea.
She's younger than us.
Well, not now.
Mummy's on
kit. I am addicted to sleeping with my blow dryer.
How does that happen? I love it.
Also, like, Lloyd runs up a blow dryer on average 8 hours every night.
That's nearly 3,000 hours a year.
I was 8 years.
Your electric bill must be through the roof. Fan heaters and all that, they take up so much electricity. They're so expensive to run.
It's insane. I don't know how has no one in her life been like, is this gonna make you really poor?
Going to die.
like you're gonna burn your sheets to death. You're gonna, I don't know, burn yourself, burn your house down, girls. And then like your electricity bill is gonna be like £7,000 a week.
Sold when the first time I remember sleeping with the blow dryer. I used to share a bed with my older sister, Tani, and she one night turned on this blow dryer. And the sound of it, the warmth of it, just instantly put me to sleep. And from that night forward, I was hooked.
When they took that shot, right, were they like, just lie in bed and pretend to be asleep and here's the blow dryer?
I think
all of it is staged. I'm always like, how?
Literally. Like, when it comes to shows like this, I know in the beginning we were like,
is it real or is it fake?
But like, as soon as you hear something like this, I'm like, you're addicted to sleeping with your hairdryer. How unhinged does that sound? And like, she's a mum, she seems like she's got her own house, so she must be like, you know, fine at like organizing things.
Mm.
I mean, the way that she kind of said it, like, you know, I liked it, like it's warm and it's windy, girls. Like, I can sort of understand like a comforting aspect, but like, just get an electric blanket. But also don't, because you'll burn your house down.
Yeah, or just play the sound of it. Like, I mean, I'm about back and then I would have like rain sounds on my phone.
That's true.
From like 2009-ish time, so like it's not...
Yeah, but it would be different to be like, I bought a portable rain shower and now I sleep with a fountain in my bed. Like, that would be, that's what she's doing, basically. Do you know what I mean? Like,
I can't get to sleep unless I'm sleeping in Trafalgar Square, girl. I need a fountain.
I need to be face down in a fountain, girls.
Typically, my nightly routine would just be to get up underneath my covers, turn on my blow dryer on low, and just curl up next to it, feel it on my hands. If I'm cold, I put it on my feet. And
oh, it's got to be a sexy thing.
It feels a bit sensual.
Yeah, it's very like, oh, my blow dryer.
Ooh, salacious.
I love it when they film these things and they're like, do you know what we need you to do? Why don't you just take this hair dryer? Crawl into bed. We're going to turn the lights off and just like film you go.
Yeah.
Because like there had to be a whole camera crew in there filming her and be like, and she had to still be thinking, this is sane and I want this to be on TV. Laurie, if you are out there and you see this, are you still addicted to sleeping with your blow dryer? Please inform me.
She's become the blow dryer.
She is the blow dryer. Maybe the blow dryer was the friends we made along the way.
Yeah.
Very often, people who are addicted, whether it's to alcohol, to drugs, or to behaviors, they often do it to soothe themselves.
I mean, sleeping with her blow dryer causes Laurie physical harm.
Yeah, it will do.
I had a really, really bad burn incident where I had like 6 or 7 major blisters. And I woke up and it was just like the blow dryer had just attacked me that night. When I see scars on her arms.
That's an interesting way of saying it. The blow dryer had attacked
me. The sentient blow dryer came with like,
and the line was on her chest and whatnot. That's a problem.
Serious marital issues.
Sharing bed with the blow dryer, I hated it.
Ex-husband.
You know, I'd wake up in the middle of the night and she's knocked out and I'm up tossing and turning.
Either you come over to my side of the bed where I'm cuddling with my blow dryer, or else, you know,
we're divorcing.
We won't cuddle at all.
That's absolutely unhinged.
Absolutely unhinged. I can understand like coping behaviors, but clearly something else is going on here. Like,
if we
buy into this and we decide that this is actually like overall a real situation that this woman is struggling with, let's just say struggling, this is something else. Have you ever heard? Ever. I knew this was going to be strange. I didn't realize it was going to be quite this weird.
The thing is, things like gambling addictions are kind of very different, but like an alcoholism. Like, but if you are willing to let your marriage fall apart because you can't cope without your hairdryer, like, this isn't like it's, again, like an addiction like smoking or gambling or something like that. But like, this is like a hairdryer. You can't sleep without your hairdryer and you're letting your marriage
disintegrate,
fall apart because you can't, like, something else is going on here. There's something else is going on.
I feel like this is very, very... I feel a bit naughty that we're watching this. I'm like, this poor woman, this poor husband was like, I loved my wife, but the hairdryer came before me, girls. Imagine losing your wife to a hairdryer.
Unhinged.
Some video of her when she was pregnant. I caught her right in the act sleeping with
it. That's what I was going to say. Overnight, I can't sleep with like any noise on. Like if someone has the TV on, I'm like, that TV is going off, sis. Like not having it.
I put rain sounds on my Google.
Even now?
Yeah.
Still to this day.
Google Play rain sounds just because I find it soothing. It's not because like I can sleep without it, fine, but like I just find it comforting. I'd love nothing more than on days when like it's during the daytime, it's pelting down with rain, but it's warm so you can have all the windows open. And it's still like, you feel a bit cut, like snuggly. Like when we were on the balcony that time, when we were on the other house and we were outside and it was raining like anything. How amazing was that? It was so soothing. So I like having rain sound on just because it has like sort of like soothing, comforting.
That's true. But like a loud hairdryer that's also hot. The one thing I don't want to be when I'm overnight sleeping is hot. Imagine being like, I've just brought the radiator to bed.
Yeah. I never understood how anyone can sleep with a hot water bottle.
Oh, well,
it's a boiling hot water bottle. I'm like, don't touch me, don't come near me. You can't hug it, you can't cuddle it.
Because you're going to just get like severely unwell.
Yeah.
I bet there's people in the audience here that will be like, I love my water bottle.
I'm unsubscribing because Rowley has assaulted my water
bottle. Girl.
People witness what I've had to learn to live with. Witness someone that sleeps with a blow dryer.
She's
like a blow dryer expert. I mean, she looks at the wattage, the bolts.
I really like to be able to adjust the heat setting at night. This one doesn't even have a cool button.
Imagine being like, oh, I like to adjust the heat setting on my hairdryer. Surely that's like a default function.
Yeah.
Imagine if I just, you know, my Dyson. Imagine if I was like, I just really need my Dyson in the blow dryer.
Yeah.
So this whole series has like been slated in reviews, being like, it's fake, girls, it's bizarre. But this is really a strange addiction. Like, I mean, it really is what it says on the tin, isn't it, here?
So this is a no-go.
Oh, it doesn't have a cool dryer. 3-year-old daughter battles an addiction, sleeping with a blow dryer. Oh no.
When we were sharing a room, she definitely had to have it.
No. This is unacceptable. No. This is unacceptable.
She'll come in and she'll curl up on my blow dryer side most of the time. As long as I'm using it, she's going to be partial to it.
No, this is
replace that. Replace that with anything else in the world. Anything. Replace that hairdryer. As long as I'm using it, she will also be a part of it. Like, that's unacceptable. You're going to, like, as she said, she's literally woken up with, like, blisters across her chest.
Yeah.
You're doing this to a child. This is unacceptable.
Unacceptable. Okay.
It's taking a turn, girls. A turn for the worst. University Park.
My name is Kesha. I'm 34 years old and I live right outside Chicago. And I love eating toilet paper.
Unhinged.
How do you...
Is this like a ballet thing?
I started eating toilet paper probably in the sixth grade.
This has to be a trauma thing.
Surely. Something must have happened.
At the time, I went to go move with my grandmother and my auntie. Leaving my mom and my brother and sister, it could have been stressful enough or be traumatizing enough for me to start a new habit.
This isn't a habit. This isn't just like, I'm wearing my parting on a different side. This is like, you are eating toilet paper. Like, this is so unhealthy for you. Please stop eating toilet paper.
This is a time in most normal development. Girls are needing to find an identity, at the same time needing to have someone to go back to for nurturing. So a disruption in that, you would imagine, could be very emotional.
Yeah,
every time you sing Kesha, she would have tissue in her hand and she would try to hide it behind her back. And if you tried to take it from her, she'd get upset. I've never been able to understand why she eat tissue. And I never will. I think I crave it because I love the way the toilet paper feels on my tongue, how it dissolves when it hits my tongue.
Okay, so take all of these things out of the equation. She could easily exchange that for things like rice paper, like flavored rice paper. That's an actual sweet treat, so to speak. But to actually be like, no, I like to eat toilet paper, like, something has happened to Kesha.
Yeah, like, why, why toilet paper? We still haven't been sold, like, what made you suddenly go, because it hasn't started.
If she runs out of toilet paper, is kitchen roll okay? Do you know what I mean?
Drywall.
But this, it's one of these things where it's like, how did this start?
How did you start?
I like that tissue paper. I'm going to eat it now. And then just not stop.
Did you get scented toilet paper? Like, oh, I smell like the smell? Because sometimes I'm like, oh, well, because we've got...
candles.
I'm a candle gay, so I've got candles all the time. So, like, I smell it and go, ooh, I wonder if that would taste nice. I would never obviously taste it, but, like, I would love a taste that tastes the same way it smelt. Tissue paper doesn't smell of anything. Like, did you get scented tissue paper? And it was like, ooh.
Like a patchouli type situation.
Yeah. I can imagine maybe she had something like that and was like, oh, let's see if it tastes as good. I don't know.
Something's going on that we're not privy to just yet. Is this common?
Maybe she was on top of tiaras.
Maybe, yeah. Maybe she won the crown. Like, would you say you have anything strange that would be like this detrimental to your life? Something like this?
I haven't really told anyone this. But I love going into public toilets and like picking out people's faces.
Oh, stop it. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Anyway. Kesha eats half a toilet roll of paper every day. That's more than 100 pounds in the 23 years.
My favorite is this one. And the reason why is because it's 2-ply and it's easier to digest than some of the 2-ply toilet paper.
You don't digest it.
And I would just separate the ply.
This isn't food.
And then pull it.
Oh, Kesha, no.
I beat it.
If I was the person filming this, I'd be like, stop, what are you doing?
It is kind of a bit weird, isn't it, how the film crews involved aren't like told to be like, stop, yeah, can we just interrupt you there? You're actually really injuring yourself and we're filming it. Like, it's just such a weird concept, isn't it?
Yeah.
But how did production come in and be like, it's not be really good. Exploit these people. Yeah. Exploit some girls.
It's like kind of like freak show circus. We love to watch people being crazy.
Yeah,
kind of.
Yeah, it is.
It's that. It definitely is.
Eating toilet tissue is not normal, Kesha.
It's not about normal.
Do
it's not healthy.
Know that you've been eating toilet tissue for 23 years? You never thought about it? No.
How would she manage to survive?
You say something like okay, that well, about you think it. About it. It has to have some kind of effect.
Taking in any foreign substance that is porous, that is fibrous, can build up in the stomach.
Yeah.
If it
doesn't
digest, it can cause bowel obstruction.
But not even that. Like, we don't know how this toilet paper is made. We don't know what bleaching process the wood has gone under to become paper. We don't know, like, any of the, like, chemicals used in the dyeing procedures, because like it's not designed to go in the body, which means it doesn't have to meet any regulations of things that go inside your body.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Shocking, really shocking.
That can be potentially fatal.
I carry it with me in my purse.
Oh no.
When I'm in my car, I keep a roll in my glove compartment box, and I'll just grab the toilet paper and break it off and start eating it.
Oh, Kesha, stop.
A good place where people really don't pay attention to you eating toilet paper is the movie theaters. It's dark in there, so you can like sneak a couple of sheets in with no one even noticing.
Sorry, but like...
Can I check your bag, ma'am? Why do you have 8 rolls of toilet roll?
Yeah, literally. But also, like, it's almost like she's really thought about this. Like, she's like, you can go to dark corners and just... Yeah, but you could just stay at home and eat it as well, surely. You don't have to go to movie theatres to eat it. But do you reckon this was, like, a leading question? Do you reckon, like, production must have been like, where do you like to eat it the most?
Oh, yeah, they would have asked her, like, those kind of things. Where do you go? Have you been caught?
Yeah.
What's the
have
best place?
What's
the best place to do it? Like, it'll be... Yeah, it's definitely, like...
Oh, it's because... Without any of these leading questions that we're told, it just kind of sounds like she's just like offloading this information.
If I eat too much toilet paper, I have like stomach cramps. I have a hard time going to the bathroom.
All we can do is just pray that, you know, you stop eating the tissue.
No, madam, you don't have to just pray that she'll stop doing this. You need to really be like, how do you shift an addiction out of people? You really have to be like dedicated to them as a human being.
Yeah.
If we are to believe that these addictions are real, which they do sound like, both of these addictions, although they're obscene and bizarre to, you know, like a typical standard, someone really needs to step in and be like, you're going to live with me and we're going to kick this addiction with together.
Yeah.
Because like, she can't do it by herself.
She has to want to.
I do understand that concept of you have to want it
you
to change.
You have to want to, yeah.
People don't just change by themselves. They either need to change or they don't.
Yeah.
She doesn't understand that I've tried and I can't stop. Like any addiction, you can't stop. I eat it every day, morning, noon, night.
150 squares of toilet paper a day. 1 million squares in her lifetime.
Today I'm here at the coffee shop to meet my sister.
But also, did you see that sign? Lunch special. So she's going to go in this restaurant and just eat toilet paper. And they're going to be like, oh, you come to the restaurant, girl.
Do you have roasted beef flavour?
She's trying to convince me to stop eating toilet paper, so I'll see how it goes.
Like, well, I wonder what she actually is eating, because she has to be eating to survive. So like, I wonder what she is eating on top of that.
Do you think this is just like, you know, like as we would have like a sweet treat or something, she's just like, I'll just treat myself to some toilet paper.
Yeah, like the toilet paper is almost like the snacks.
Yeah. Oh, this is so dangerous. I cannot believe we're literally, like, this was on TV. Like, the amount of people that would have seen this and been like, I've never thought about eating toilet paper. Maybe I should eat some
There's
toilet paper.
There's a blue roll over there.
Oh,
maybe
we should have a nibble, yeah.
When was the first time you ever started eating tissue anywhere?
I really don't remember.
What made you want to eat?
That didn't sound
nice. That didn't sound.
I really don't know.
No.
My sister sometimes jokes with me, and then sometimes she can get really serious when she's vocalizing how she feels about me eating toilet paper.
What are you trying to look to see if somebody's looking?
What's up?
No.
Try it.
Would you want some?
Yes,
I think syrup and tissue go together. Keisha said, as long as she's not hurting anyone, that is fine. Well, I just think that she should really take it serious, because who eats tissue?
That can clog your system up.
No, it can't.
Yes, it can.
It's not like I'm balling it up and just stuffing it in my mouth. I'm taking like pieces.
But don't you
Yeah, but you're eating a half a toilet roll.
Also, she did just say earlier, when I eat too much, my stomach gets very upset.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like she feels like she might be being attacked at dinner. Do you know what I mean? It's that kind of vibe.
The thing is as well, I think with this is like, she said, as long as I'm not hurting anyone else, but she actually is.
The more that we're watching this episode, my heart is kind of like going from like, oh, this is ridiculous TV, to like, oh, this is a horribly serious situation and these people need a lot of help. And I feel like this TLC has come in and gone, oh, let's look at the shock freak
like,
girls.
What did they do? Like, what did they put, just call it how? Are you addicted to something weird? Like, what did you-
Can we just film you doing this weird thing?
Like, what did they say to get people?
It dissolves and break down.
How you know that? It dissolves and break down in septic tanks and stuff like that, not your body.
Yes.
You never know. It may kick in when you 40. You're like, what the hell is going on with my body? They're going to say all that damn tissue ate.
Listen to your
sister. She's on the ball.
I'm worried about you. Mom's worried about you. The kids worried about you. I know it's going to be hard for you to just stop, but you should really consider not doing it at all.
I really do want to stop, but I don't know how, I guess.
That's why you
just think now that sounds like a real addiction.
With addictions, like drug addictions, when they stop doing the drug, they get away from the drug. There's no escaping toilet paper.
It's an addiction, and I think
I'm actually quite gagged about that. That's completely true. There's no escaping toilet paper. I mean, I should get a bidet.
You could get a bidet, or so you could use, like, well, I was going to say, you could use wipes, but then when you start eating
You start eating wipes. The thing about it is, there's also, like, any public restroom is always going to have toilet paper.
Yeah.
Always. Yeah. And if you stop eating toilet paper, just like we mentioned earlier, is kitchen roll?
Yeah.
What about any sort of, like, tissues? Kleenexes?
Yeah.
Very strange. And what about, like, normal paper? Is she also, like, if nothing's available, I'll have normal paper? You can't just escape paper.
She can fight it. I'm willing to support her in whatever it is that she does, but this tissue eating, it has to stop.
Nothing.
Austin, Texas girl!
Back to the hairdryer.
The blow dryer has become a part of who I am. I am very addicted to the heat and the sound. So it's been 24 years now. I'm still sleeping with the blow dryer.
24 years?
My girlfriends Micah and Erica are not crazy about the blow dryer. They worry about the dangers.
I've watched you be addicted to the blow dryer. And you have to understand why it really bothers me. I don't have sisters. You're my sister. And to watch you go through something
literally
that
just what you said. Yeah. Just what you said.
In yeah. your body and could potentially kill you.
Yeah, it's very
well, she got electrocuted in her sleep.
Yeah, I've had burns over the years. That's the part that bothers me so much about the whole blow dryer thing is because it is hurting her physically.
Also, how can an electronic be on for like 8 hours? Like over like something like that that's literally designed to meant to be like maybe like it's half an hour maximum.
Yeah.
Something like imagine having straighteners on, like hair straighteners on for 8 hours. The heat and like the danger of death, girls.
Because like the back of a hairdryer, especially those ones, get really hot.
They do, they
like,
really do.
Like sucking all the air in, because I have long blonde hair, yeah. So I've had to use lots of hairdryers. Like, but that because of that, like that would quite easy catch your bed on fire.
Easy
to catch fire.
Especially back when like 24, if this was 10 years ago, let's say, she's been doing it for 24 years. Back in the mid 90s, a good old-fashioned house fire.
How she's not had that, I do not understand.
No, she's been very, very lucky.
It is an addiction. I mean, even though it seems kind of silly to us in the outside world, it's something that you have had to have for so long. It is an addiction and needs to be taken seriously. Why is it that you have this addiction?
I don't know.
Oh, something.
I don't know.
Yeah.
What is it that comforts you and what do you need that for? And maybe how can you?
There's a lot of things involved.
Calm yourself and
Mike?
Sleep soundly.
It's psychological, it's physical, it's mental. When I do think about the long-term effects of it, you know, that does concern me. I don't want to be 65 or 70 and still whipping out my blow dryer at night. It is weird.
Deserve to be free of any kind of addiction.
Does it kind of like emulate like warm breath, like a mummy's warm breath?
Maybe.
I know that sounds like a weird sentence, but you know, like being like cradled as a baby and be like, ooh.
Maybe. The thing is, the only thing I can maybe think of is like, not even necessarily like the heat from it, because I know she's talked about it.
The vibration?
Like, even like, I think maybe it could even just be like the noise could have been like a masking for when she was younger. Maybe it's like what happened when she was younger and the noise, she used like a noise that was almost like that to mask out the sound of people, like the parents arguing downstairs or something.
Yes.
Or like some, you know, these kind of things really can mess you up as an adult.
Yeah.
And you don't realize that it's kind of stuck with you.
I do also kind of feel like maybe both of these people are kind of holding back a bit, which like, to be honest, if some company came in and was like, hello, we're going to talk about your difficulties, girls.
Yeah.
I would be like, I'm not sharing everything with you, sis. Yeah. It's very strange, isn't it?
Fiction. Mm-hmm.
You know, and you're too beautiful really to have things like this.
Right.
you're too beautiful to be burned and
scarred. I'm just ready to like break free of this addiction.
Yeah,
too beautiful to be burned.
Behavior.
Only ugly people can burn themselves.
Weird.
I don't want any more fire hazards. I don't want Dre to grow up with it.
I'm really happy that you're seeing it for what it is. That it is a weird addiction, and it is an addiction, period.
Okay, so what's going to happen from here? Are you going through some type of counseling or something to help you? I'm going to go check it out, see what they tell me, see what I can find out. Whatever is determined, we're going to be here for you to make sure that...
Good, good, good.
It's not going to be an issue anymore, because we know that you really do want to quit.
Yes.
And that's the first step.
For Lori, I hope that with all of this, she can see what has caused this addiction. And not only can she stop using the blow dryer, but she can really see what is at the root of this addiction.
I do kind of feel though, this documentary team has come in and been like, should we stage an intervention, girls? That'll make excellent TV.
Yeah.
Have you got a sister? Have you got a friend that cares?
Yeah, like I wonder how they did that as well. Like, we want to get your friends involved. Like, let's get them talk to you. Like, what did they...
How did they, like, sell this to these people?
I think what it is, it's going to be a little bit like things like Embarrassing Bodies, where it's like, we will pay for the therapy.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
If we can put you on our TV show. Yeah. So, like, you're going to be shocking the nation, and people are going to think you're absolutely crazy, but you get free therapy.
Therapy, so, girls.
I think that's what it is.
Oh, okay.
I think that's quite logical.
That's quite a logical conclusion of the
but
situation.
But I do think that's almost predatory. I do think
it
that's,
is very that's, predatory.
Hi, we want to make a show and exploit your pain for our... amusement.
But it is also very, it's very Jeremy Kyle, it's very Jerry Springer, Maury Povich, like it's all very that, but it's in a slightly different format.
Yes, yes, for sure.
Mm.
When I think about quitting the blow dryer, it's a very uncomfortable feeling.
Why is there sellotape around the outside
it's,
of
it? Maybe she's trying to tape it somewhere.
I'm excited, I'm curious, I'm a little apprehensive.
Oh, we're not going to see it. It's just like... film the therapy. What's the music? She's getting over her guitars.
I have been battling a different kind of behavior. I sleep with my blow dryer on at night next to me, and it helps me go to sleep, and that's kind of why I'm here to talk to you. I am a little selfish with my blow dryer. I don't want anybody telling me that I can't use it. It's just part of me. I don't want to go without it. When you're talking about this, it does sound like it has addictive qualities to it. I think any addict that I've ever, or alcoholic that I've ever asked, why do you use? You know, what do you get from it? People will tell me all the time, I don't have to feel. There is a numbing that does happen when I turn it on, because I kind of zone everything out. So tell me, if you were to think about not using your blow dryer to sleep, what kind of feelings come up for you? Uneasy, uncomfortable, a little anxious.
Yes, absolutely.
To cope with life as a tool to escape. The thought of giving it up is like giving you, like cutting off our right hand or our right arm, you know, it is
I've had enough of that today.
No, I've tried to quit before, but I don't know that I ever really gave it 100%. Do you think you're at the point in your life where you want to give it 100%? Yeah, I don't want it to control me anymore.
There were some weird noises coming from down the hallway, by the way.
Yeah, ghostly ladies.
Suddenly we were like,
Spook the woman.
Spook, yes.
Oh, it's the hair dryer
of doom.
I love eating toilet paper. You're not supposed to eat toilet paper. You're supposed to
Jenny's
eat food,
the most sensible.
But I eat toilet paper as well.
Do you reckon it's like a secret
thing as well?
Do you think they're like really secretive?
So she can give me a little...
I'm really secretive about it. Hears me on national TV.
Oh, true. But I mean, Embarrassing Bodies is the same vibe, isn't it?
Insight about me eating toilet paper. I still don't think that there's anything wrong with it.
See, this is the thing.
This
she's
is
not going to change.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's in touch.
How long have you been eating toilet paper?
Dr. Susan Wojcicki.
I can remember.
Susan!
Like 23 years.
I'm 23
longer.
Years.
How old are you now?
I'm 34. I don't think it's a problem. I don't think anything can happen.
You know, one of the classic symptoms of addiction is denial and minimization.
Mm-hmm.
Tell yourself, it's no big deal. I've been doing it for 24 years.
Absolutely.
If your intestines rupture inside of your abdomen, that could be fatal and could be fatal pretty quickly. You know, as a medical professional, I can tell you that.
Yes. Is that going to shock?
You're putting your body at risk and really playing Russian roulette with your life.
I find those kind of things really difficult for them to even really comprehend anyway, because it's like on smoking packets, you see like the horrific pictures of like people dying of cancer.
Yeah, and you kind of get desensitized.
Yeah,
to
you kind of desensitized. I don't know what's like around the world, but in the UK now, in our smoking cigarette packets, on the front of it, it's literally like people dying.
Yeah.
But dying of like cancer, lung disorders, everything. And their lungs like black and like holes in their necks. And it's like horrific to say that, but it's on cigarettes to kind of make people stop.
Yeah, to make people understand the danger of that product.
Yeah. But so like, so for her even just to be like, oh, it's going to harm your health, I just don't think it's going to do anything.
I don't think it's not a strong enough conviction until something happens that maybe frightens her a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, it's very much one of these things where I've done it for this long, there's no problem so far, kind of thing.
Yeah, for sure.
Poor Kesha.
My mom says my inside is on a bus, so I guess that's what she means. Is there any warning before that happens?
Not a whole lot. Not a whole lot.
Okay.
What do you think about that?
Why have they got tissues on the table?
It definitely gives me something to think about.
She's probably only thinking about those tissues.
Yeah, she's been going.
Why are they staged like that as well? As if they're just ready to be plucked at any moment.
Literally, that was Ella.
It would be like the other lady going to that room and they're just being like blow dryers. Be like, we're gonna have your therapy in a salon. Ridiculous.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
And no, because it's always gonna be there.
You know, for people who are alcoholics, when they leave residential treatment and we send them home, we recommend that there be no alcohol in the house.
But you can't do that with toilet paper because—
Yes, you can.
What are you gonna use?
There are other sanitary wipes besides toilet paper.
Diaper wipes.
You know, there are ways to have your house be toilet paper free. When I was talking with Kesha, it seemed as if there was a wall up between us that she was not willing to let down. That's not uncommon the first time a patient meets a doctor.
Yes.
You're picking up a gun that has one bullet in it, in many chambers, and pulling the trigger.
Right.
And you feel fine when you pull the trigger and a bullet doesn't come out.
And one day, when I pull it, I might just not be so lucky.
Yeah. She sounds a little bit like Lady Gaga.
Makes me sad.
So often, you know, we're crazy busy and we're stressed out and we're going at 90 miles an hour and then, you know, we brush our teeth and lay down and we expect to go to sleep.
Right.
You know.
You can't just shut off.
I'd like to see you learn some of this deep breathing techniques.
Okay. Yeah.
So that your brain starts slowing down and you start relaxing. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm all about meditation and prayer.
Meditation might be a good one for me, being able to put myself in a very peaceful state. To be able to kind of slip right into sleep without feeling a need to
But if you knew that, you might already be doing it.
Yeah,
or, I feel like an intervention is needed. Like
that. One thing that's been really beneficial for some of my clients is to write a goodbye letter to their addiction. You're going to talk to your addiction about all the things it's done for you.
Talk to your blow dryer.
Why you loved it so much. But then you're also going to really talk about why you need to let it go now. Lori is out of denial, which is a major first step into getting into the road of recovery.
She has very blow-dried hair as well.
Yeah.
Very blow-dried.
This gives her knowledge that she's strong to do other things in her life, and that can be really empowering.
Ink toilet paper for 20 years.
I get very, very uneasy.
I have health problems from doing it. When I try to stop, I continue to do it. I wake up and still do it the next
day. Please, Kesha, stop.
People who have a predisposition to addiction and who are caught in the grips of it can't stop on their own.
Yeah, well,
even if they really, really want to.
Yeah.
Dependent on this behavior.
I'll try to cut back some more.
I think therapy would be really important, both individually and in group, with other people who are struggling to let go of compulsive behaviors.
I'm willing to.
That's what it is. It's not an addiction, it's a compulsive behavior.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is. It's not a strange addiction, it's a compulsive behavior that needs to be broken.
Yes, for sure.
And you can unlearn behaviors. You absolutely can.
And I want to stop too, and I think I'll try to stop. I'll put forth the effort.
At some point.
Now, Kesha. Inspired by Dr. Dennis, Kesha looks at how much toilet paper she's actually eating every day.
Oh, God.
Oh! That is a block of wood.
There's a lot of tissue that I've been eating for like so long.
Every day, that's inside you.
It was.
Oh,
my next step is gonna be stop eating tissue altogether.
All of that is in your stomach.
It don't hurt to try. I'll try.
Every day. Kesha is fighting her addiction to toilet paper. Instead of eating it every day, she's cut down to twice a week.
It's always nice to have.
I mean, stepping stones, but also like just
for taking steps towards, you know, something positive and in the right direction.
The first step is admitting you have a problem, and I'm gonna take steps to conquer it.
With the help of meditation, Laurie has stopped sleeping with her blow dryer.
Oh, wow.
She admits she still craves it and occasionally uses it during the day.
I was still better, but...
Dear blow dryer addiction, although we have been together for many, many years now, I'm ready to let you go. You have hurt me, scarred me, and caused me pain. For that, I am ready to let you go.
Okay, come on.
I will not allow you to control me any longer, blister my skin, or draw me into you. I will not remain a prisoner in my bed or in my life any longer. Farewell, addiction, dependency, and blow dryer. You will be remembered.
Wow.
I mean, I definitely feel like Laurie was ready to do this.
Yeah, absolutely. Right, my lovelies, we've pushed my laptop away from us there, and we're going to just talk a little bit about what we have seen today, because I've got conflicted feelings.
Yes,
I didn't know quite it was going to be quite this way, but you were really onto something there when you said going cold turkey from something, like eating tissue paper or toilet tissue. Remember when we did that video, it was the aqueducts, so they turned to GHB in the stomach?
Yes, yes, yes.
Is there possibly a coating or a process that toilet paper goes through, a pulping process that has a residual chemical in it that as she's eating it, her body starts to crave?
Maybe.
Like alcohol.
Maybe.
Or something like this. Maybe it's not just a case of, I'll stop eating tissue, you'll be better. Maybe it is a case of...
There's something in it that's like...
As she started, now she's like, I actually can't stop because it's a physical addiction.
Yeah, maybe there's something there. Maybe there might be something in there. Because... we know that toilet paper does have some kind of chemical in it.
Yeah.
So maybe it does do that. And I guess because no one eats toilet paper, really. Like, that's the thing. I'm sure other people probably do it. I remember my brother used to do it sometimes when we were younger.
I mean, everyone's eating like a bit of tissue or so. You know, if it's on a bit of food and you're like, oh, it's just a bit of tissue.
But like, I wonder if, especially ones that are like flavoured ones.
Like scented ones.
Yeah, like maybe there are ones in there that have like some kind of chemical that makes you addicted.
That's really weird. I'm a bit uncomfortable, actually. I'm not sure how I feel about what we've seen today, my loves. Odd experience that we've had today in the studio, my love.
And I don't think I could be with someone who would want their hair dry on all the time.
Absolutely not.
I'd be scared that they would catch fire and I'd die.
Yeah, well, also, but like, it sounded like that man had put up with it for like years at that point and was just like sick to death. Everyone has like a couple of strange quirks about them that you can be like, all right, not my favourite, but you know, I still love you, girl.
What's your strange quirk?
I like to
eat babies.
Much less like Luke.
Sorry, I've had too much caffeine. Now I'm on the crash. I'm on the sugar crash.
I'm on the crash.
I'm on the crash.
On the crash. Anyway, my loves, thank you so much for joining us here today. Let me know what you think about what we've seen today in the comments box below. And it is time for La Patriones.
Oh!
And a gorgeous hello and welcome to Wendelin, Ellie Sealy, Kathleen Maguire, Kelly Lum, Travifull, Kit Hover, Sarah Lizard, Brocky Bears, Keaton Kramer, Megan Rhea, Adrian of the Stars, Annie Feingold, Mangal, Ryan Vita, Lefty Lucy, Feli Pink, Sam and Chris, Christy Elliott, Laura, The Opinion Queen, and Natalie Vanstone. Today's Twitch shout out goes to Dinosaur Nurse. Thank you so much for following me over on Twitch, you stunning woman on the go. And if you want to be in with a chance of being featured in my next video's Twitch shout out, make sure you follow me on Twitch. It is Luxeria Plays. And I stream 3 nights a week. That's Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, my loves. And a massive thank you to the top tier Patreons. Kelly Loom, Erwin Fox, Stephanie Niatupski, Defutech, Casey Donahue, Travifull, Ryan Vita, Elizabeth Stone, Celine Yates, Lane Wade, Caitlin Coating, Min Min TM, Caitlin Wright, Jenny Hendricks, Abigail Ash, ContraPoints, Victoria Waldock, Succubus Lena, Shell Herman, Jodia, Jara Pavlovsky, Jevod, Orko Samoji, Moldy Apple, Victoria Carella, Megan Holly, and Dana Broderick. Gorgeous. Thank you, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And with that, my loves, make sure you look after your friends and family.
Yeah.
Just make sure. Make sure you tell those in your life that you love them.
Make sure you check the toilet paper in your house.
Gout.